Gamer from the golden years of video games, also known as the 90s. Granted, my time was somewhat earlier, but this was the time where potential and evolution in storytelling and video and computer entertainment was just beginning. Yes, the days before the internet. Nintendo really started something special when Mario, Link, and friends ran the show in the late 80s. And not long later, a ton of companies would want to join in this up-and-coming industry. And they would as either the competition or third-party developers, whose interests weren't usually so much as to rule over it, but instead use their tech to create worlds and adventures for us geeks, nerds, and consumers alike.
Now at the time, the only two major companies that were competing for greatness were, well, of course, Nintendo and Sega. And in the later years, they would be followed up by a new competitor. And it's at this time where the retrospective is going to actually begin. And the franchise that we're going to cover is actually owned by NAMCO, whom in later years would join forces with Bandai and then fuse together and become Bamco, or Namdai.
Okay, everybody is definitely familiar with Namco, with their popular franchises from Pac-Man to the success that is Tekken. But as popular as they are, there would be one that is even more popular. In fact, it is so popular it has its own yearly festival, its own stores, even its own cafe. Damn! Granted, these things are only in Japan, but whoa! Talk about fan service!
Yeah, you know we're lame when the best we can do is get shitty movies and, well, maybe some porn. Shh, Japan goes all out, man! I was born in the wrong country!
But what is this franchise I'm going on about? Well, it would be none other than the Tales series.
Never heard of it? Well, don't be surprised. Regardless of it being a very endearing and popular mainstream game in Japan, it has actually managed to maintain a very low profile here in the States.
This is mostly due to Namco's poor advertising. Unlike other popular titles, well, like Tekken, Tales games would never get any TV ads, let alone any poster ads. It's never clear as to why exactly, but most would argue it's believed that foreigners just really wouldn't appreciate the same kind of storytelling that Japanese people do. You know, either that, or Namco just has worse luck than Mega Man fans.
Ouch.
Presently, there are over 20 Tales games, ranging from mothership titles to escort titles. The difference? Mothership means the mainstream titles, such as Fantasia, Destiny, and so on. Escort titles are the fan service filler games made in between the mainstream ones, and those themselves offer entirely different gameplay experiences as well as supplying non-canonical Elseworld stories.
The escort titles are mainly considered what-if fanfiction Elseworld stories, if all of the mainstream title characters came together and hung out and went on adventures, and possibly you can create a character to interact with them and that sort of thing. You see, there is so much going on with this Tales series that it would be practically impossible for me to cover it all in just one part. That being said, this Tales retrospective will have a series of videos with each part of me covering a mainstream title, with the final episode covering all of the escort ones. So, technically, I'll be taking you on the same journey that I did, and, well, that's the gist of it.
For the upcoming episode 1, our first step takes us all the way back into caveman days of 1995. Where the legend began. See you guys there.